When in France, do as they do. They're all down at the beach enjoying the Quicksilver Pro France this afternoon. It's a glorious Saturday. A big round three unfolding here. The Gold Coast, Chloe Andino from the talent bed that is San Clemente in California. And we'll get Chloe Andino underway. A strong leverage for the first turn. Speed now over the lip. Transitions beautifully. And wow, a little rocket boost over the lip section, but he'll go incomplete. So early momentum from Chloe Andino here. You see the little 1 point score, so a little up and out for Jack Freestone previous to that.
But in that trench, there's that rip. It's creating a little bit of an A-frame. So just enough of a corner there to work with. That's why we saw this left-hander kind of behave just a bit. Nice floater there for Chloe. Climbed up over the top, but with that low tide, it gets really shallow. It gets dumpy. It's hard to finish those moves.
Jumped up one position on the Jeep leaderboard with a 13th place at Trestles. So that what he wants to beat a 13th here in France. And here he goes, Jack Freestone, tight whipping. Little over executed there as he loses that center of gravity momentarily. So that'll be a throwaway score in the context of this round three heat nine encounter. And Ross, have you figured out what those instruments were that were playing?
Madeline and an accordion, is that right?
Yeah, oui, oui, monsieur.
Ah.
Let's have a look and see what Chloe Andino brings to the beaches of France. Tight hook up in the pocket. Almost gets lost there. And well does, because his momentum is blurred on that delivery. And Andino, so little mistakes from both surfers here in that exchange.
That hasn't happened for Jack or Chloe in his heat, so a bit of a slow start here. The waves are tricky, though. Very walled up.
Windless conditions playing here on a Saturday afternoon as Freestone goes vertical, tight to the pocket again. Now loads the second one, nice little variation there. And a little skip of the fins as he links the third turn. So tapered corner here.
You know, kind of keep your eyes on the prize. And Jack right here, speaking of keeping his eyes on a prize right there, bangs the lip, so a nice start. Finds himself a little open face right here. This wave did not close out. Allowed him to tag it three times, but nothing super special there, just kind of going to work. This wave had a lot of potential for Chloe, but unfortunately for him, he got hung up on that first turn, so he didn't get that projection down the line that he needed to connect with that second maneuver, and as a result, really got kind of hung up on that lip.
We move to the bottom of the tide graph. You're joining us in the second half of this round three heat nine encounter, and here we go with Chloe Andino. And this is a much better performance now. Little head snaps included as he completely buckets out these turns. Another aggressive snap. Strong mechanisms to his approach to each maneuver. And he'll stomp it. How about that for a little bit of French passion right there?
Would not be surprised if it's into the 8 point range or higher. This first snap, pretty nice, but setting the pace. This one's the money one. Buckets out the back. That is a power hack and a hook. And then a third little wipe right there. And this wave continuing to roll down the line. So you can see, I love Kaloa's backhand. You know, a lot of us get kind of caught up in how explosive he is on his forehand with those big airs. But when he winds up that backhand attack, he is vicious. Is there any inside scoops to Julian? I know earlier on in the year he was working with Jake Patterson. Does he have a coach right now?
Yeah, I think it's his girl. She's been by his side, and they've been hanging out and having a good one. And, you know, I think that...
sort of like a workshop at a Grand Prix circuit, right?
It is. It's really cool to see their routines as they warm up the muscles and basically their reflexes. You'll see a lot of those little kind of funny routines with balls. They'll jump around, they'll catch.
With a little over 9 minutes still to go, bringing our attention back to the requirements for Jack Freestone here as he takes off. Second wave of the set. Little bit of a confusion track there, looking at the tube, possibly looking at the lip. Freestone won't find the 6.51 with that.
And so I think he was going to maybe try to pull off a quick little alley-oop, but didn't get that ramp. And so again, this low tide, some tricky conditions, very walled up. There's that straight line, so he's trying to get just any little elbow space he can get his board up on to the lip to get that tail floating, and he does not. He got totally denied by that lip, so that wave closed out before he could react, Giggs.
Oh, falling in the falling lip, Jack Freestone. So obviously, Ross, a little bit of concern there. And now we'll stick with the live action, because down the line goes this man, telegraphing, and to the rotation he goes. Love that little body statement at the end.
You know, never mind waiting for a perfect wave, just get it done that way.
Now Freestone looking for more opportunity. So both surfers selecting right-handers here. We just saw vehicle upon vehicle pouring into town here last night. Camper vans aplenty. Let's see. Yeah, Ross, what do you take from this?
I just always think it's so impressive how surfers on tour, they're so casual with moving their body around in the air, and they respond just like a cat reflexes. So in the air, his front foot shuffles towards the nose of the board and uses the rocker of that board, the nose of the board, to kind of pad that landing. Again, watch his front leg. He's going to find that section, gets a little space right here, and hits the ramp. There's that front foot so easily shuffled forward. And that allows him to really smooth out that landing. Uses the rocker of the board.
So the coaches seem to be putting their eyes and paying attention, because we talk about, as we see action in the water here, Kolohe looking at a beautiful wall. How does he pull this off? No, he doesn't. But that kind of time frame that is set up right before is a really critical time, because right before the heat starts.
Pete, we're going to test your flying wall skills. Any word from the coaches? Where are they making him sit?
Well, I'm not quite that. I don't want to get that close. I don't want to invade their space too much. But, you know.
There's a sailboat out in the horizon. It seems to be just stuck there. Not a breath of wind.
And now Freestone, with the 90-second mark approaching, will try and engage. And he does not find any form of unlock there. You know, he was telegraphing, looking. You see where his thought pattern's going. But this is a little bit uncharacteristic from Jack Freestone. Stop on our schedule, the Quicksilver Pro on the Gold Coast. And now Freestone again, just exploring, not finding anything.
This is big. Big result for Kolohe and Dino. Maybe one last little scrapper. Nope. So I think he's going to have some accordion French music in his head right now. That was a pretty smooth win for him. One last little air attempt for Jack Freestone. And he's going to be happy with that one, moving on to that round four.
So Kolohe and Dino will steer this thing now to the final buzzer. Little rotation from Jack Freestone's not going to knock on the door of any requirements in the excellent category. And Kolohe and Dino will find his way to round four.